I don't recall.
And I remember pulling out in the motorcade and they weren't following us. And I was like, Bret, you have to slow down. They can't follow us.
That was the time I had my heart thing. That was the time when I went to the emergency room because I was having chest pain. Because that was when they came up and I snowblowed before, and then we went in the snow and you were telling me to slow down, and then on the way home you took me to the hospital. We definitely were there. All right, I will try and be home by 3 o'clock. My last patient is at, I know, I will. Yeah, my last patient is at 1:45, so I will be there. Okay. All right, goodbye.
Right here, right below the rib cage here, I start feeling that there's something sitting out there like a wall.
Have you seen the pictures from the endoscopy?
No.
Okay, so I'll show you. This is where the scope's coming into the stomach. Okay, this is looking back up. That's the tumor. Okay, and what you have, unfortunately, is the high grade kind, which is called the signet ring cell variety.
My spirits are high, you know.
Well, that's good.
And I want to beat this. I want to say I'm cancer-free.
There you go. That's our goal, too.
And I just hope that you're the best of the best. And I just hope, I hope. I'm too young.
No, I agree.
Just for comparison with the most recent scan, so back in June, one of the findings was a little hypodense, like a 6 millimeter lesion in the right.
How you doing?
Great.
I know.
That's a lie.
I know. It's normal to be nervous. That's okay.
Petrified too.
Petrified is normal too. We're going to take good care of you today. I promise you that, okay?
Yep.
When we put that camera in there, if God forbid we find cancer somewhere else, we biopsy it. If we prove that the cancer is outside of the pancreas, then we stop, okay? And then, you know, it would be back on with chemotherapy.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's always a balance between risk and reward. And there's a pendulum of, you know, emotions and anxiety and feelings as you go through this process.
All right, but no issues with latex or betadine, correct?
Correct.
Any metal anywhere in
and
your body?
What is the potential risk we're gonna have to face for the potential reward? And is that reward high enough to justify the potential risks we're gonna have to take? Nice warm blanket. It's a very challenging conversation to say, you know, there's a good chance you could have a significant complication that could change your quality of life. But if you don't do the operation, the cancer could spread and you can die. And that's always the fear in surgery and the balance. Every time I do this, it's a very delicate dance. But back in a kind of a tucked corner of the liver back there, I found that mass on the liver. So I was very concerned it was metastatic disease.
Judy, it's Gabby in core 6. Can we get someone to come down and grab a frozen specimen, please?
This was very hard, it was very firm, it was white. And there are times when you have to make a decision in the operating room as to whether this is going to be a go or a no-go.
Well, I mean, that's the thing with this disease.
Yeah, you're doing
terrible.
You know, it's sort of a tough moment because I'm starting to think about, okay, now how am I going to have the conversation with her after surgery? You know, we found something, we had to stop, and unfortunately, you're not going to be cured from your pancreatic cancer. You know, that's a hard conversation. So I start to think about that. And those are the challenging, you know, moments where it becomes very human. And you could have done everything right, and those are sometimes what weighs on you. So she has had multiple stents placed into the pancreas because of pathology. Hello?
Hey guys, it's Christoph. So it's a calcified little nodule.
Yeah, it was pretty big and ugly in the liver, so I was concerned.
Oh boy, all right. It's really, really calcified, so I wonder if it's just post-treatment effect that's possible. Any way we could get a little more of it?
There's really not much more. I gave you the whole thing.
Oh, you gave me the whole thing. All right. All right, let me get a level. Call back.
As a surgeon, those are sort of the most traumatic moments.
Some levels on the right liver lobe mass. This thing is most likely a calcified biliary proliferation, some sort of bile duct adenoma. There's a couple of atypical glands in there, but in context, we're favoring it's reactive. It's not diagnostic of malignancy here.
Okay, so negative for malignancy, dysplasia.
All of a sudden, it's not cancer, and then that excitement and energy comes back again. And then you go through the operation, and then you get to the point again where you're trying to assess whether it's going to come off the vein and whether you're going to be able to make the tunnel and is it going to be resectable. And, you know, the pendulum swings again to have those moments of fear, to have those moments of success. It's a dance. And then you move on to the next challenge.
All in all, I would say surgery was a success.
Thank you.
This kind of thing is a team sport. It's not a one-person sport, so.
Yeah. Well, I'm grateful for the team.
Medicine is filled with turbulence. As a two-physician family, my kids know all too well what it means when the pagers go off. But if I'm otherwise capable to help, how do I say no?